Pwede tayo ngayon sa derivative of algebraic functions, no? So, kung naalala natin yung sa ating high school, yung formula ng ating slope, which is m equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 all over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Okay, considering this figure now, meron tayong dalawang points, di ba? So, to get the slope, we use this formula. Okay? So, mula sa x sub 1 hanggang kay x sub 2, yung distance na yan ay yung tinatawag natin increment of x or difference of x sub 2 and x sub 1. Okay, that is the horizontal distance between x sub 2 and x sub 1. Okay, then delta y or increment of y, that is the vertical distance between y sub 2 and y sub 1, or vertical distance between the point 1 and point 2. So, since equal pala yan sa distances between two points, okay, so we can write now m is equal to, okay, palitan lang natin. So, m equals delta y all over delta x. So, dito sa derivative, slope is the basic of developing the differentiation formulas, no? Or the derivative. So, ito yung ginagamit para makuha yung derivative. So, dito ngayon, let's consider this figure. So, meron tayong dalawang points, point P and point Q. Okay, then yung ating pinaka-graph, which is y equals f of x, ano? Meron tayong y as a function of x. Now, considering y equals f of x, okay, kung papalitan natin ngayon yung y ng y plus delta y, so ito yun, ano? Mag-move daw yung ating y pataas. So, y plus delta y, ano? So, ito yung ating delta y, di ba? At ito yung ating delta x. So, kung papalitan naman natin yung x ng x plus delta x, mag-move naman daw, ano? Pupunta sa x plus delta x. Okay, so, substituting the values, so, y plus delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x. Then, we transpose y, kabila. So, we obtain delta y equals f of x plus delta x minus y. So, since y is equal to what? F of x, ano? So, we can rewrite delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x. So, ngayon, kung gusto nating kunin yung slope ng ating curve, which is y is equal to f of x, we're going to divide both sides by delta x, ano? So, we divide both sides by delta x, we obtain, okay, delta y all over delta x is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x all over delta x. This now is what we call the average rate of change of y with respect to x, okay? Now, if we want to get the derivative of this figure or this curve, okay, we get the limit of delta y with delta y over delta x as delta x approaches 0. Kukunin natin ngayon yung limit. So, yung limit ng f of x plus delta x minus f of x all over delta x as delta x approaches 0. So, this now is what we call the instantaneous rate of change of y with respect to x. Or simply, the limit is called the derivative of y with respect to x. Pag tinuha natin yung limit ng slope natin, ano? And then, na delta y all over delta x, yun ngayon yung ating derivative. So, kung naalala nyo, so ito yung pinag-aralan ng mga nasa STEM siguro, or nung sa iba, nasa high school pa, yung three-step rule, ano? Yung ginawa natin na yun, ano? So, derivative of y is equal to f of x can be denoted by, so pwede natin yung symbol na pwede natin gamitin para i-denote yung derivative. So, we can use y prime, dy over dx, d of x all over dx, dy sub x, or d of x sub x, ano? So, pwede yan, ano? So, ibig sabihin, yung ating dependent variable ay yung y, and yung ating independent variable ay yung x, no? Okay, the process of finding the derivative of y is equal to f of x is called differentiation. So, wag mali dito, no? So, yung derivative, yun yung limit ng ating delta y all over delta x as delta x approaches 0. Then when we say differentiation, that is the process of finding the derivative. So yung process ng paghanap natin ng derivative, so yung ginawa natin na paghanap ng limit, yun yung tinatawag na differentiation. Okay, so para maintindihan pa, so daanan ulit natin yung 3-step rule, ano? The 3-step rule in finding the derivative of a function. So first, so kailangan gawin natin ganito, ano? So di ba, no, dati ito ay 5-step rule, ngayon na kinompress na ginawa ng 3-step rule. So delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x, ano? So di ba kanina yung y pinalitan natin ng y plus delta y, then yung x pinalitan natin ng x plus delta x, then yung y ni-transpose lang natin sa kabila. So ito lang kinalabasan niya, di ba? So yun lang yun, ano? Then step 2, we divide both sides by delta x. So ayan, so yun yung nakuha natin. And last is find the limit as delta x approaches 0. So we're going to get the limit of delta y over delta x as delta x approaches 0. So para mas maintindihan, let's have an example. Determine the derivative of y is equal to 2x minus 3. Okay, so first, we're going to substitute y by y plus delta y and x by x plus delta x. No? Pinalitan natin. Then next, we're going to transpose y to the right. Then we have delta y is equal to 2x plus 2 delta x minus 3 minus y. Since y is equal to 2x minus 3, so pwede natin palitan. Then we obtain, so delta y is equal to 2x plus 2 delta x minus 3 minus, so quantity 2y minus 3. So kinulong natin sa parenthesis kasi meron tayong minus na operation. So distribute lang natin. So meron, magkakaroon tayong negative 2y plus 3, no? So negative, tapos magiging positive yung 3. So we obtain delta y is equal to 2x plus 2 delta x minus 3 minus 2x plus 3. So simplifying this term, so we cancel 2x dahil meron positive at negative. Also yung ating negative 3 and positive 3, no? Negative 3 plus 3 is equal to 0. So ang matitira na lang 2 delta x. So delta y is equal to 2 delta x. So ang final step natin, second step, we divide both sides by delta x. So we cancel this delta x here in the numerator and the denominator. Ang natira na lang delta y all over delta x is equal to 2. So last step natin, we get the limit of the delta y all over delta x, or the average rate of change of y with respect to x. So in this case, or in this example, ang ating slope ay 2, which per delta y over delta x is 2. Alam natin na ang limit ng constant ay the constant itself. So limit of delta y all over delta x as delta x approaches 0 is equal to 2. Or we can write it as dy over dx is equal to 2. So ganun lang, ano? Another example, so find the derivative of y is equal to square root of 1 minus 3x. So first step, palitan natin ulit yung mga yung y and x. So y plus delta y, and sorry, this is x, ano? X yan, that's supposed to be x. Type ko lang ulit. So we have 3 times x plus delta x. Then lipat yung y. So yung y natin, ang value ay square root of 1 minus 3x. Okay, so anong next na gagawin natin? Okay, hindi ka muna mag-ano agad, ha? Di-divide. Walang mangyayari sa buhay mo dyan pag nag-divide ka ng delta x. So we need to rationalize this radical, ano? Okay, so we multiply the same radicals but different sign. Okay, so dito meron tayong negative, minultiplyan natin ng positive. So para makancel, no? Para mawala yung, sorry, hindi makancel, para mawala yung ating radicals, ano? Okay, so ang ating rule, kapag same yung laman ng radical, anong mangyayari? So, mangyayari dyan, mawala lang yung radical sign. Ganun din sa square root of 1 minus 3x. So, makukuha natin. So, 1 minus 3x plus 3 delta x minus. So, since minus tayo, distribute lang natin yung sign. So, since ito mawala lang yung kanyang radical, so negative 1 minus, okay, minus, oh, negative sa negative, we have positive 3x. Okay? So, sa baba, since wala namang kasama to, meron tayo ditong 1, di ba? So, multiply lang. So, we have, kinopya lang natin yung pinang-rationalize natin, ano? So, after nyan, so, simplify lang natin yung numerator. So, merong mga cancel. Kung napansin nyo, ano, pagaya pa rin ng dati, pagka, kahit magpalit ka ng delta y, delta x, mga ganun, ano? Sa dulo, may makakancel lang naman yung mga terms. Okay, so cancel yung negative 3x plus 3x. So, kapag umahaba na yung equation, huwag kang makakabahan kasi sa dulo, may makakancel din, ano? Okay, so delta y is equal now to 3 delta x all over square root of 1 minus 3x plus 3 delta x plus square root of 1 minus 3x. So, dito, pwede ka na mag-divide ng delta x both sides. So, divide both sides by delta x. So, dito, delta y all over delta x. Tapos dito sa kabila, yung delta x natin, ayun. Okay, so dinivide lang. So meron lang kulang na parenthesis, ano? Okay, so pwede natin i-cancel na yung delta x since common siya sa parehas. Okay, sana susundan, ano? So ang natira, we have delta y all over delta x is equal to 3 over square root of 1 minus 3x plus 3 delta x plus square root of 1 minus 3x. Now, step 3. To get the derivative, we get the limit, okay, of the slope or the rate of change. So, we get the limit. So, 3 all over square root of 1 minus 3x plus 3 delta x plus square root of 1 minus 3x as delta x approaches 0. So, gaya lang din sa ating limits. Kapag tayo ay kumukuha ng limit, puna nating perception na gagawin natin ay isasubstitute natin yung value kung saan yung x natin ay nag-approach, di ba? So, 0, we substitute 0 doon sa lahat ng delta x. So, dito sa problem, isa lang, ano, meron tayo dyan. At wala namang magiging problema kung isa-substitute natin 0. So, makakancel to, magiging 0. Yung 3 delta x, mawawala na. Kasi 3 times 0 siya, ano? So, ang matitira, so, 3 all over 1 minus 3x plus square root of 1 minus 3x, ano? So, since common na yan, common na dalawa, common terms sila, pwede natin silang pagsamahin. So, para lang tayong mayroong dalawang variable na magkamukha, no? So, a plus a equals 2a. So, same lang din dito. So, makukuha natin, 3 all over 2 square root of, 3 all over 2 square root of 1 minus 3x. So, final answer. So, we can express dy all over dx is equal to 3 all over 2 square root of 1 minus 3x. So, baka may magtanong, sir, kailangan pa bang i-rationalize? Kung i-rationalize mo pa yan, kasi di ba bawal kaya-kaya nyo yung denominator na radical. So, ang haba lang, ano? Kung i-rationalize. So, okay na to. Pwede na sa akin itong ganitong sir. Same lang din naman yun. So, yun lang.